Anxiety is a bummer. When it strikes, some resort to counselling and others to drugs, legal and illegal. Distress is what nobody wants, like garbage in your bedroom. Wished for or not, feelings of quiet desperation, call it depression, descend on us all. When it's a daily occurrence, enduring for all one's waking hours, something drastic needs to be done. Switching on the tube, shopping, going to the movies, binging on food or alcohol, just don't get it, not long term anyway. What we do and the people we see most often affect us. Adages like Shaw's, "You are what you eat." "A man is known by the company he keeps," reflect this. The jury's still out on the heredity versus environment debate, and genetic engineering will further confuse things. The foundling baby Karuna was raised by a charioteer and displayed extraordinary martial skills in later life. But Betty Hurst, daughter of media magnate William Hurst, lived over 2 decades in prison because of crimes due to an alliance with the Black Panthers. Association, particularly intimate association, chosen or otherwise, rules us. Just as ingesting tablets unknowingly alters behavior and physiology. One can contract malaria or TB by mosquito sting, or by breathing a sick patient's single bacterium. One scanned cell can do great harm. Disease knows no mercy. The Bhagavad Puran says, symptoms ultimately determine character. And character is what finally determines mental state. If we model ourselves internally and externally on people we respect, maintaining their values, we unconsciously exhibit their qualities, whatever our everyday life and work circumstances.